Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel again. It's that magical day. I finally put this thing into my lineup. It is Doom Turtle Day. It's my first 10 today with the T95. I've had this researched and purchased forever, I just hadn't put it into my lineup. Alright, so I brought 30 shells based on the War Thunder Wiki article that said 30 was enough for RB. We'll see. It gets rid of one of the ammo racks and a partial ammo rack, too. We'll see how this thing works. I've been dreading doing the first 10 for this solely based on the speed and maneuverability and some of the maps being large, but thankfully, they fixed the spawns on Second Battle of El Alamein, so they're not as far away as they used to be, which was one of the reasons I hadn't been doing the first 10 for this. So hopefully, we get some good maps here. Honestly, I hope I only get the arcade size maps. I just don't want to deal with having to drive this thing across make a ton of turns, go up and down hills, turn while going up hills, etc., that kind of thing. So let's hope that this map's not too bad. It's not too small. But I'm hoping that I don't get what's the other map besides El Alamein that's Battle of Hurricane Forest, that's what I'm thinking of. I hope Battle of Hurricane Forest doesn't become a regular in this first 10. So, I've got a 30% research booster turned on, and because I just happened to get one yesterday with the Wheel of Poverty, and I've got... Alright, let's see. Let's see how she turns. Well, yeah, not great. But it's got relatively decent engine power for moving up this hill. It's not moving quickly, but at least it's not straining to get up the hill. It's just slow. Wow, okay, we're fighting just the Germans. Somebody's got a Kugelblitz out already. That's the first spawn. Oh, so let's see. Can we see my lineup? Yeah, there we go. Alright, so normally this is my M46 tank crew right here. But that crew is spaded out, and I wanted to be able to get research done on my other 6.7 vehicles, so I briefly considered using Golden Eagles and buying a 7th crew for the US just to make it a tank destroyer crew, because I already have, this is my medium tank lineup, medium tanks crew, this is my light tank crew, that's my heavy, and that's my AAA. Alright, somebody wants to play. See if they're foolish enough to let me know where they are. Huh, they are. He just got killed, didn't he? I'm shooting him anyway. Yep. Darn it. That probably would have been a good kill there. Side shot in a Panther. But anyway, I don't really honestly figure on using this tank destroyer overly much. And when I do, I'll just make a 6.7 lineup like I have right here and just use it in the medium tank slot where I have the spaded M46 instead. So, yeah, unfortunately I kind of have a feeling this is going to be very similar to the first 10 for the Tortoise, where what you guys are going to be watching mostly is a mobility first 10. I'm giving her all she's got, Captain. This thing is definitely going to be an airstrike target. Oh boy. I do have research switched over to parts. I was tempted to switch the research to the APC-BC shells for my first research, but we'll go with parts first, because a damaged engine or damaged tracks on a vehicle with no turret is a death sentence, basically. So while I expect that to be a problem several times in the opening of this video, there's guys with airplanes already, and I haven't even made it to the battle. Ugh. There's a reason I hadn't done a first 10 for this so far up to this point. Oh, yes. And I've got so many first 10s done and uploaded at this point that this is video is being recorded on November the 18th of 2016, and you guys aren't even going to see this video until January of 2017. So, how crazy is that? Now, I could release the first 10s more often right now from what I've got recorded. However, I want to do them on Fridays specifically, so... This is the final one of all the first 10s that I recorded right after the War Thunder anniversary sale in October and November, so... I assume by the time this one releases, I might have something, one or two more vehicles from other trees and lineups possibly finished and recorded for first 10s, but as of right now, as of recording this one on 18 November, this is the final one I've got. Oh dear. Well, this could be a problem. Come on, buddy. Come on, you can do it. Thank you. Appreciate it. That was very helpful. Alright. A little bit of team help there. Let's take out the binoculars and see what we can see. Nobody... Oh, I was going to say, nobody's in the usual hiding spots, but somebody is. Somebody is in the usual hiding spot. I don't know what a 128 can do to this thing. Oh. Well, alright. We'll take it. We'll take it. I don't know. I think I probably just blew that shot. Oop, somebody else is up there. What else just shot at me from up here? Oh, there he is. I see him. Okay, I did. It was me with the shot. I just blew the shot low. That's a Yag Tiger, I do believe. Is it a Yag Tiger or is it a Tiger 2? Actually, I think it's a Tiger 2 now. Alright, let's see if we can spot that. Kugel Blitz, there he is right there. Yep, he just got killed. Okay. I swear I just saw something move right up there. I think that's a Tiger 2. Alright, we're gonna move in and get joined up with the A point here. Those guys down there, how are they? Yeah, we're heading for A. Doom Turtle away! Now, I've got to cross this ditch up here that I can't imagine is going to be a pleasant experience. It's going to be interesting to see how long this first 10 lasts. I don't imagine I'm going to die as quickly as your average first 10, simply because it's going to take me that much longer to actually make it to someplace where I can get killed. So... this could be interesting. Bombing, I assume, is probably how I'm going to get killed most of the time. Now this... yeah, I was going to say the M2 Browning on the top of the on the ring on above the commander's cupola there is supposed to be supposed to ring around almost entirely to backwards, but not quite directly to backwards, so I can't quite get to where I can shoot at the bomber that was just going over. Alright, we got her lined up. We're just going to autopilot it into the A point now. And hope that we don't get bombed, because there's definitely a bomber up. There he is. That's a... those are MGFFs going overhead. Yep, there's a 190. 190 right there. Oh my god, there's a... oh, we are going to get airstruck for sure here, but I'm going in for the cap. I have a feeling bombs are going to be the end of this first battle, but if that is the case, so be it. We've got AAA. It'd be nice if the AAA looked up at the sky. Okay, AAA. It'd be swell if you guys looked up at the sky now. Just lost my commander, which means I have no AAA defense on my own. There's nothing but airplane. There we go. Thank you. That's one down. Well, alright. You got one. He did his job, anyway. Do we have anybody else who's AAA on the team right now? I think one coming out of our spawn, looks like. No, we don't even have... What is he... No, that looks like AAA. Oh yeah, there he is, M19. I just didn't see him. I have no machine gun now. There you go, good work. So either I'm going to get the cap here, or I'm going to get airstruck, or we are going to kill them out. Or we're gonna kill them out and the battle's gonna end before we get this cap, because this cap is not moving quickly at all. Well, that'll help. I'm just glad I'm still inside the point. Dude, don't sit right next to me. Well, as I have no breach, I'll move over to the edge of the capture zone here so that we're not all getting bombed by one bomber. At least as much as possible. Try to find the edge of the capture zone. That should be roughly it.
Attention to the map.
Well, that's a little scary. And there are the bombs. Well, I'm just staying inside the zone in case my engine gets knocked out. If I get bombed, I get bombed. So be it. That was... really? How? How? Let's see in battle 2. Alright guys, here's battle number 2, and yeah, oh, what a lovely spawn this is for the T95. Glorious. Well, thanks for the attempt to try to push me up the hill, guys, but I really don't think it's gonna work. So I didn't really consider the possibility of a break map for the T95. That's awesome. I swear, it's like there's an algorithm in this game's matchmaking that's like, oh, you turned on a gigantic booster? Let's give you a horrible, horrible map on a battle, so you get no possibility of any research. Oh, you just used a booster? Oh, here you go. Here's break on Eastern Europe. Guaranteed capture. Oh, and then 5 guys on the other team are going to spawn in AAA and drive right in front of you so you can kill all 5 of them. Oh, you just used your booster? That's too bad. Alright, well, we got out of the hills anyway. Now we can cross the rivers. What lovely terrain for the T95. This is actually sort of funny. Alright, sent Mark 10. Well, it looks like we got a slight up tier if there's a Centurion Mark 10, but that's okay. The worst it can be is 7.7, which is not the kind of matchmaking I want to see either. Guys, believe me, I would defend the A-point if I had any possibility whatsoever of reaching the A-point. Honestly, I don't expect to really make it to the B-point in time to have anything to do with capturing it. Unless there's quite a fight going on at B. Which is a possibility, of course. We'll see. Come on, Tiny, gun the engine. Oh my goodness, 1 mile per hour going up this hill. Good lord. This is what I was scared of doing the first 10 for this, which is why I just put it off forever and forever. Just the terrain. What are you dumbass AI shooting at? It's dead. Whoa, easy. Really? This a tank this big and heavy is skidding out on the rocks? And we're capturing B again. And we're skidding on the rocks again. Ah, watching that Carnarvon speed away from me reminds me when I was talking about how slow the Carnarvon was. Alright, now just do not, absolutely do not fall off this bridge. Believe we're lined up straight enough. Shouldn't be an issue. And we're gonna capture B. Yeah. I should have, this is what I should have done. I should have waited until we captured, B and then spawned in, and then spawned in up there. Oh, I saw you, Panther. Not that I can do anything about it, but I saw you there. Oh my god. Now I have to react to this Panther over here too, because if he shoots me in the side and sets me on fire, that's it. What a waste. He could pop up anywhere up there, and I can't possibly make it down this road to get away from him, either. Well, that's lovely. I don't think that's AI, either. I mean, that's gotta be a real player. If I go chasing after him down there, he's just gonna pop up on the hill to the right. I guess that's what I've gotta do, though. Oh my god, that takes me absolutely completely away from the new B point. I don't know how vulnerable this thing's side armor is to a Panther 75. Okay, he's up there. Maybe he thinks I just kept on driving. Well, I don't know. Somebody else spotted him on the map. I'm gonna turn in towards B in a second here. Once I clear this spot right here, I think. Okay, was that a Stirrer Emil I just heard shoot, or was it a Yag Tiger? Because at this battle rating, it could be easily either. One of those I'm concerned with. One of those I'm not as concerned with. I'm afraid this might be a lot of what the first 10 is going to be, just me driving around. Like I said, this is where I hope I get all the arcade maps. I love Jungle. Jungle is one of my favorite maps. But, it would have been probably, pretty much would have been fine if it had been anything except Break. Break was probably the worst battle type this could have been. And were this anything but a first 10, obviously I would not have spawned in the T95 on a Break map. I would have gone in my... Well, okay, so that answers whether or not a Panther long 75 gun can kill you. He killed me in one shot. Okay, well there you go. That's a mercy. We'll see you in Battle 3. Hopefully there's no more Break. Alright guys, here's Battle number 3. I consider Battle 2 to have been a mercy killing on that Panther. lucky him, he got to shoot right into the, basically a flat panel there from the angle he was shooting at. I did kill a Tiger II, 105 Tiger II, with my M42 after that, though, so there was that. Too bad it wasn't, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, come on. What am I stuck on? We're gonna... Oh, come on. No, no, no. Oh, my God. No, backwards. No, 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 no. Backwards. 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 Other way. Backwards. No. Not forwards. All right. You know what? Pull me then. Pull me forwards then. Okay.
Thank you.
God, what a... I hate that crap. There's stuff under the snow that you can't see, and it's enough to get you stuck up on the middle of it. It's all over this map. Alright. Anyway, before I got sidetracked and untracked, I did kill a 105 Tiger II with my M42, with the default rounds, no less. So, like I was saying, too bad that wasn't the point of the video, because that would have been a highlight. Conquest again. So, no chance for a capture, but I'm not really looking for captures, honestly, in this. Even if we get a... even if we get break on, like, Eastern Europe or something, I'm not going to make it to the first capture point before the rest of the team does, and I'm certainly not going to make it there on a conquest. I might be able to make it to a second capture point on a linear... domination map like Eastern Europe, but I don't even think I make that. Because somebody else in a fast tank will just go for the second capture point. At any rate, I should be able to do some relatively decent long-range shooting down the long straightaways here on the railway yards, so we'll do that. Believe, can I get up here? No, I can't. I can't get up on the train platform. That's too bad. Let's see. Well, we got some guys over here towards A. And some guys behind us. Oh, alright. Well, they're taking A. I guess we'll head for A then. We'll go down to the next... We'll go down to the next bit and then turn up towards A. Something just went by, but I'm pretty sure it was friendly, judging by the direction it was traveling. I just caught it moving out of sight. Come on, turtle. Come on, turtle. Come on, turtle, let's get some place where we can take a shot at somebody. Come on, baby. Of course he was already dead. I wasn't paying attention because I was zoomed in, and then the guy behind him got killed. Well, maybe we'll get a cap after all. Except, he's not capping, so somebody's still inside the point. There we go. Alright, well, we'll move in and go for the cap, I guess. Really like to get a shot into somebody. Would really like to put a shot into somebody at some point during this first 10. It's never not happened before, but we'll see. We've certainly got a lot of chances to get shots at people. I don't really feel like I need to fully reload my ammo, so... Ooh, Tiger 2 back behind. Oh no. Thought I was gonna get bombed, but I guess I was gonna get one shot again. Let me guess, it was from behind, because I didn't turn that way and look. Interesting deflection. Very interesting deflection. Alright gang, here's battle number 4. It's Conquest again, and an urban map. So, not the worst, not the best. At least the spawn was relatively pointed in the right direction. Let's see here. Us and the Russians against the Germans, alright. No Britishers to worry about. Hey, I'm not the only T95, yay! Oh, that's cool camo, I like that. I think the T-44 is trying to help the T-95 along. I wonder if it's actually speeding him up at all. Oh, God. Thanks, PT-76. I don't think you have quite enough engine power to push me along any faster. I can't really think of anything really to talk about here. Just more of the same, more driving. Doing everything I can to get to the battle as quickly as I can here without hitting any obstacles or roadblocks. One of the biggest things I see about the T-95 is the absolute, very real danger of being flanked before you make it to the battle. By faster mediums or even light tanks with, like, heat FS type things like the PT-76. Getting around and hitting you in the side, knocking out your tracks or your engine or your driver, and then being able to just drive around you and blast you at will wherever they feel like. Definitely a very real danger. It's like the only conquest battles I've ever had where my team That little metal piece right there on this broken streetcar stops my tank from going forward. Hey, finally, somebody shoots at me. From the front. Of course, I can't see them because of all the smoke and other friendlies in the way. But at least something finally shot at me. Straight ahead, guys. Straight ahead. Up there. Up there, forward. T95's taking shots in the back there. Come on. They're capping A. the heck? Where's that guy that was shooting at me from up there? Holy shitballs. Of course he's dead. And of course there's no indication that he's dead, like everything. No, come on. Ah, couldn't get in there in time to stop him. Is he dead too? Sure is. Well, let's go find whatever just took A. There we go, there's something to shoot at finally. Let's hope we can get around this wreckage. Come on! Ah, that's some garbage. Alright gang, here's battle number 5. Naturally it's Conquest again. When I'm driving a light tank in a first 10, there's nothing to be found but battle, battle, battle. Now when I would love to see a battle map, so there's a little bit of time to actually make it to the fighting, it's just Conquest, Conquest, Conquest. Oh well. That's the way of the matchmaker. Let's hope we can get to where we can actually see somebody. I ought to be able to see somebody from up on top of this hill right here maybe though, so... Maybe all is not lost with this map. Maybe, just maybe, make it up to the top of this first hill here and be able to take some long-range shots on some people. I'll give it a minute or so at the top of the hill, see if I can spot anything, and if not, then we'll continue pushing forward. At least the capture point is on the same side as the same side of the map as I am here. Come on, turtle. You can do it. Come on, turtle. Goodness, this is barely even a hill. Our team is capping A, and I haven't made it past the first hill out of our spawn. God. Alright. Let's sit here for a minute. Clear some lines of sight, and see if we can see anybody coming. This might not actually be too bad. Okay, there's somebody shooting from up there. Well, there's something I hadn't really noticed yet. The gun traverse is relatively good. Let's see how far... It's actually not too bad as far as gun traverse goes for a non-turreted vehicle. That's not actually bad at all. Somebody's right up there that I just can't quite see. See if I can knock this tree down. Maybe get some visibility on him. Take this tree down too and see if that helps. Sorry guys, this might be a little bit boring. I'm really sorry. There we go, okay. That's AI and I don't even care. Actually, you know, that might not even be AI. It also is farther back than I anticipated it was. Yeah, I think that's AI. Wow, I missed again. Jeez. Honestly, I can't tell if that's AI or if that's a real player. If I can dial the shot in on it, we'll know. Yeah, that's a real player. That's a real player. I don't know why he's driving one of those. That looks like an F2, maybe a G. Pretty sure it's an F2. Yeah, alright. Well, look at that. It's a kill. Not only a real player and a live player, not a dead one that I keep shooting at, stuff that gets killed seconds before I draw down on it, but an actual real player and a live player. Alright, it only took until the fifth battle, but we got a kill. And it only took about 5 shots to dial the range in, too. I haven't taken a shot that long in quite a while, honestly. Let's see, does this have... No, it does have the rangefinder. Okay. I'm sure the rangefinder there would have just told me it was farther than 600 anyway. But still, it does have the rangefinder. Something to remember when I'm driving long-range shooting-type vehicles like this. Alright, well, we're moving on up down the road. Oh. T-44 just got hammered. Let's get up top of this little elevation here and see what we can see. There are definitely some hostiles. Or T-44 or something. Just, oh, there's a real tiger. I wonder if I can... get a shot on him from right here. No, not right there. Let's see. I don't think I can, actually. Nope. Alright. Up top of the hill we go, then. Worried about getting flanked from up there now. But we're going to worry about defending the cap more than anything. Please don't hit this tree. It's exactly what we're going to do. There's no way we're not going to scrape this tree and knock it down. Look at the gap between my tank and that tree. Oh my god, tiger right in front of me. Climb! Climb! Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Right into his gun mantlet. Come on, guys. Reload! Okay, it's not a tiger. Thank you. Come on, M46. Come on, M46. Get involved. Come on, M46. Get involved before he shoots you. Just a hit? Awesome. M46, shoot him. Come on, thank you. Got down here. Oh, I guess that's what we got. Let's see if we can get reloaded fast now. Okay, that works too. That works too. I'll take a kill and a couple of assists. That's more like it. That's more like it. That is more like it, team. Well, T95, really. The teams have been okay so far, but finally a productive match for the T95 here. I mean, I've been making incremental bits of research based on just tanking hits the couple times I didn't get one shot killed. Come on, swing that 50. Keep moving. Alright, they're down pretty far. If that 17 finds me. Oh, he is going in the ground. No, he's not either. Wow, he pulled out of that. I'm actually kind of surprised his wings didn't come off. Oh, he's bombing our guys up near their spawn, that's why. Somebody's... guessing through the smoke, trees in the smoke there. Alright. If that's the way you want to play, little AI. Fine. We'll have no more of that. That's hilarious. He blew one of the extra tank road wheels off. Where'd that shot just come from? Well, we are going to win this one, and barring any last-second bombings or random tanks with a big enough gun to kill me that are somehow still left alive at this battle, we're going to survive this battle, too, so... Battle 5, finally something productive. One real kill. Couple assists. There it is! Did I call it or what? Every time! Alright guys, this is battle number 6. And look, it's domination Eastern Europe. I'm not even going to head that direction. I'm going to head towards C. Battle 5 was finally a productive match. Yeah, just drive in front of the T95. It's all good. It's fine. Don't worry about it. And then we got domination on Eastern Europe. So a nice little linear map. Maybe Battle 5 will be the turning point, and 5 through 10 will be nice productive battles. We can hope. Let's go. Let's hook our right here. And then head up towards C. C should be pretty decent fighting to happen. Let's see if we can get a fast enough running start to clear these stupid things that are slow you right down. Here we go. Charge! Let's see what speed we can get up to before we hit the trenches and come to a complete stop. Apparently 7 miles an hour. Who are we fighting here? Alright, the Germans and the Russians. Actually, that cleared the trench without too much trouble. This might be a problem. I've never crossed this trench at this spot right here before. Alright, actually, not bad either. Okay. Finally. There we go. Okay, come on. Seriously? Just straighten out. Alright, let's get to the battle, fellas. Let's get to the battle. I guess 7 miles an hour on hard-packed road surface is the best you're gonna get. Oh well. Good to know. Too bad these battles don't last an hour or I could actually drive 7 miles. Let's see if anybody's made it across the river yet. That's a bit of a concern. Alright, well, we've got some flankers of our own over there, so... Ordinarily, I'd be mildly annoyed by that just because of concentrating on the capturing objectives, but in this case, I don't really want anybody hitting me from the side. That is a Tigray. Come on, stop it! Are you kidding me, gun? What the crap was that? Okay, guys. Here's battle number 7. It is domination, but we're going to head over here and travel up this road where there's a nice straight long shooting and hope that we don't take yet again somebody spawns in front of you after you're already spawned in and moving. I don't blame the Ag Tiger at all there. There's nothing he can do about it and he can only move so fast. It just, why didn't he spawn in the same spot I had spawned in after I'd already spawned there and cleared out of it and moved forward? At any rate, let's hope the driver hatch BS doesn't happen again. You had to go outside of me there, Ned Stark. You couldn't cut inside of me to go up the road. Whatever. Dude, what are you doing? Alright, let's see what we can see here. Too bad you can't fire the machine gun from the commander view, from the binoculars. It'd be cool if you couldn't fire the main gun, but you could still shoot the machine gun from up here as long as it would reach wherever you were looking. It's going okay so far. Neither great nor terrible, honestly, I would say. I mean, even on what should be technically hard road here, well, I guess we're still making 7 miles an hour, so that was the same I was getting on actual, no kidding, hard road, so. Fair enough, I guess. Too bad the enemies didn't want to come play over here down this road. I figured this would be my easiest chance to get into some direct fighting, them all the way down the other end of this road, but I guess they all went down the middle in the cities. Of course, we're fighting against Russians, so... Oh, here we go. Oh, look, an IS-3. That's... fun. Holy God. Alright, well, we've got some company now. We're gonna go for his barrel. Well, okay, here we go. There we go. That worked. I actually under-aimed there and shot just a little bit lower than I meant to, but that's good because I was not actually aiming for the lower glacis, which is what I hit there, so that works. That works just fine. Okay, let's continue moving forward here. Alright, that's what I was trying to do. There, I hit what I was aiming for. Alright, Yag Tiger, you keep that side guarded, and I'll keep this side guarded, and we should be okay. I don't think I can hurt him from there, not from that angle, not with these shells. Yeah, I see you too, buddy. Although somehow I'm not hitting you like you were hitting me. Interesting. Nice. Ooh, we got a bit of an up tier here. This is a 7.7 battle, which I should have realized when I saw the IS-3. Although I don't remember what the IS-3 is anymore. It's probably a 7.3. Oh! Tell me he hit the driver. He hit it, didn't he? He hits the driver hatch, isn't it? Oh, that is such a garbage... Alright guys, this is battle number 8. Battle 7 wasn't too bad. I had a nice little additional boosters there. Too bad those didn't come the battle before. Two team 10% research boosters there. So with my 30 and those two, it ended up being a 46% research booster. That would have been nice in the battle before there where I had the kills and the assists, but that's okay. It did alright. I got a tiny little bit of research for my M56 as well. Oh well. Some for my M42. My M42 survived like 4 hits from a T-44-100 at close range, which I thought was kind of hilarious. I just kept blasting away at his gun barrel, trying to knock his gun barrel out, and eventually he blew his gun barrel, but he still was able to kill me because he set me on fire. Oh well. So that whole drivers or commanders. No, I guess it is. No. I guess it's the commander's hatch. No, that's the commander hatch back there. I guess it's the gunner's hatch right there. The whole gunner's hatch cupola there where everybody shoots the T95. That sucks. That really sucks. What a crappy weak spot. That's the biggest thing for watching out with this. The speed and that stupid cupola there. That's what's going to get you killed 90% of the time. It'd be nice if I had the 105 nuke shells for this thing, but there's no way I'm going to get those finished within the confines of the first 10. I almost went for those for the research, for the first tier modification research, but I figured the default shells are okay. They're obviously not the best, but they're okay. And as far as things go, getting the engine disabled or the gun breech knocked out or something is going to be a far worse scenario than having slightly substandard ammo. So that is why I chose parts. Okay, it's us against the Germans. Anybody out there? Somebody's right along the side of there. Somebody's right up there, too. There, I think we can get a shot at. Yeah, and he knows it, too. Alright, we just gotta watch out for over there. That's a problem. I'm not terribly keen on this spot, honestly. Quite a bit vulnerable from the right hand side. Here we go. Well, he'll be able to back away from that. Like I said, the default shells are usable. Hey, tanked one. Actually, you know, I haven't really had an opportunity to check the reverse speed, and it's about just as bad as I thought it was going to be. Hello, I see you. Oh man, I can't traverse down enough. No! Go away, you stupid thing. Oh, come on, the Panther 2 killed me? Let me guess, he hit me in the gunner's. It has to be the gunner's cupola. There's no other way he could have killed me from that angle. Oh dear, that sun is less than pleasant. But anyway, here's battle number 9. It's all the Allies against the Germans. And it's battle on AC-85. For half a second I thought that was a Su-122-54. Oh, I'm glad it wasn't. Let's see, what do we have here? Oh yeah, it's battle on Eastern Europe, which is good, so let's see what we can do here. Kind of looking forward to getting my ASU-85. Kind of. A little bit. It'll be an interesting first 10. Plus, that will take over my, probably replace my PT-76 as a light tank in my Russian lineup. I wish the Tiger II's gun had been that good when I was driving my Tiger II-P and Tiger II-H. Primarily, all the heck while long ago, and I wish the Tiger 105 had been the same. Oh well, I'm glad at least the 105 mil gun on the T95 and the T29 are supposed to be supremely performing now, too. Because they certainly weren't initially when I first unlocked the T95. I don't have the T29. Sun is going to be a problem. Holy cow, our team is getting rocked. All right, I do at least have an outboard flanker. I hear a German machine gun over to my left somewhere already. Okay, what was that? Okay, it is from behind this building. Alright, good. Let's see what we can see. Oh my god, they've got a KV-2 Desert Spider. See how quickly can we swing? Not very quickly if somebody comes around this corner. Not very quickly at all. Goodness. Oh, he was mine in the lower glacis. Crap. Where is that coming from? I guess right there? Oh, there's somebody right here too. Okay, fine. Jeez. Oh god, that is getting real old real fast. Alright gang, there's, oh god, battle number 10, and I got frozen pass and have to climb the hill to get to the capture point. Obviously, I'm not going to try to do that. Let's see if we can even make it up this hill. 1 mile an hour up this hill, this is going to take 20 minutes. Alright, we'll go climb up this road here and try to get into a supporting position where I can cut off the, I'm assuming the Germans, yep, where I can cut off the Germans trying to cut across and attack the point. This isn't exactly the map I was hoping to see last. But hey, at least it wasn't Hurricane Forest. There is that. Alright, well, while I've got about 25 minutes here to get to the 25 minute long battle, let's talk about some final thoughts before the final thoughts. So there's such a stupidly gigantic weak spot on this tank that you can hit from any angle. You can shoot that driver, gunner, cupola there in the front from any... You can hit that from any angle, and the shell is going to detonate inside. From the front, obviously, is the best, because then it detonates on the hinge hatch. But I can't see anybody hitting that thing and it not exploding and killing most of the crew inside. So a gigantic glaring weakness on this tank, that a tank destroyer, that honestly, I can't see myself ever really using this thing. There's no point for the frustrations of how slow it is to get anywhere and having no turret on it. If there was a way to guarantee certain maps you'd be able to play and see, then maybe, but for the most part, for me anyway, I can't see me ever using this in my 6.7 lineup, not when I can bring in the M46 or anything else that's 6.7 instead. Let's see if we can get a shot here. Oh yeah. Have some, pal. It is good for that. It's certainly good for certain things. If I can get the reload down fast enough, I could put one into the side of that Panther or Tiger P, but I don't think that's going to happen. Maybe he'll come out around those rocks. No, he is right down around those rocks. Maybe he'll show me himself over there.
Enemy forces have captured a zone.
Alright. The mobility is as expected. I mean, I'm not going to complain about the mobility any more so than... Obviously, what do you expect with the T95? But at the same time, it is another large drawback to it that you can only move 7 miles an hour. And that is a bit of a problem. The gun is good. I mean, I've got a fair amount, not a lot, but the targets I've been able to see and shoot at, I've done pretty good serious damage to with the default shell. So, with the APC-BC shell, obviously that's going to be better. But really, if you want a good American tank that uses the 105 gun with the APC-BC shell, you might as well buy the T29 and get a research in Silver Lion boost too. I can't honestly recommend using this thing other than a funny thing to drive every now and then. Oh, this is just ridiculous. Alright, let's climb at an angle then. See if that'll work, or if it's just gonna twist and slide sideways. Okay, looks like it's gonna make it. Alright. Now I really hope I don't have to go up to the A point and actually try to capture it, because that's insanity. Our team is up there a bit. Is that a broom bar? No, it's a Ferdy. I didn't think that could have been a broom bar. Okay, that's friendly AAA shooting at the Ferdinand. We'll move up to where we can get another shot at him. Assuming that we can reload fast enough. I believe we're going to be able to. Oh, yes. Alright, I got his breach. That's good. Oh, awesome. There's a Yag Tiger in the tunnel at A. Do I dare go up there and try to face him head on? Well, I'm going to head up here, take a peek over the top of this hill behind that T29, look over to the left, see if there's anything coming, and then if not, I'll slowly make my way up to the A point. I'm not sure what just dropped that bomb there. I thought it was an Arado, but I don't know. It didn't sound like a prop plane. I was only half paying attention, too. Come on, Turtle. Come on, Turtle. Ooh, what do we have right down there? Is that my T29 I just heard stop? I sure hope it is. I should be able to whip around to the left pretty quickly here if it becomes necessary. Alright, we are going to head up for A, as much as I despise that thought. That's what we're going to do. Got to try to stop the ticket bleed. Our guys are in the tunnel, so they can deal with whatever's up there, which looks like multiple German heavies up there. We can start capping. Alright, yeah, we'll pretty much call this the final thoughts piece right here, because it's going to take that long for me to drive up this hill. So yeah, final thoughts for real are just that hatch on the top over the gunner is just such a glaring weak spot that I honestly, it's horrifically bad. The gun itself is good. The mobility is, I would say, bad, but it's not bad for a gigantic, super heavy... I forget how heavy this thing was, but as heavy as this tank destroyer was, it's not actually bad for how big it was. And it turns relatively well, honestly speaking. Comparing it to as big as it is and not comparing it to, like, you know, an M41 or something, obviously, it's not bad at all. The gun isn't even that bad. And it does tank quite a few shots to the front, but if you get, like, an angle from right here, you're just shooting flat armor. And it's... the back and the side armor isn't really all that good, but this thing wasn't meant to be hit in the back or the side either, so it's meant to just charge straight ahead and assault bunkers and fortifications, so it's not really a tank destroyer so much as it is a assault gun for taking out fortifications. So to that end, I think it's pretty good for a tank destroyer. Hey, look, we're actually taking A. Maybe I can get in there and finish off a cap for the final battle. That'd be a sweet little cherry on top of the sundae. Maybe. 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 It's gonna be a close one. I think we'll be okay. I think we'll just pull in there just in time. I think we're gonna make it. Alright, and then we're just gonna park here and hold this. No matter what comes, we shall hold this point. A line must be drawn. Yeah! Okay, I'm going to defend this point. If we get shot from behind, we get shot from behind. Anyway, that's all I can really think about for this. I do, at the same time, look forward to getting the APC-BC shells, and at the same time, I honestly question whether I'll ever drive this tank destroyer again. Accepting maybe that, like, it's the last vehicle I have left that's not spaded. Maybe I would drive it then. It's not even the most terrible thing in the world, it's just... That being, I'm not even sure how many times during this first 10 I got killed through the gunner hatch there, but it was more times than I care to deal with. I guess that's the thing, is like, it's not just that it's a weakness, but it's such a well-publicized and well-known weakness. Everybody knows to shoot the T95 there. So, I guess that's my biggest problem with it. See if we can spot anything else coming here. We've got guys behind that should stop them from coming up and capping A from behind us. So if I can move up right here, maybe get to where I can see something before these M46s have a field day and shoot everything before I can even get into position. Not to take anything away from them. They're obviously doing their jobs, and I'm not going to deny them shots. Let's hope the Ag Tiger doesn't get a shot on me. Oof. Oh my god, don't slide down the hill, you unbelievable piece of junk. Oh my god, come on. Alright, thank you. Oh god, that JU-87 darn near took me out. Ooh, that was close. I don't know how he didn't get me there, unless he dropped a bomb that wasn't big enough. He certainly should have. I'm just happy he didn't set my engine on fire or black my engine out. That would have been the end of this. We might just hold on to this one. And now there's nobody up behind A, so now we need to... Great, and I fell down that ridiculous hill. I don't know if I can get back up. I could probably get back up the hill over there if I really need to. But I guess we're going to rape out their spawn, so the odds of them getting up and capping A are pretty low. Especially since they're pretty killed down. That looked like a narwhal. And a G. 109G up there too. Bye, Narwhal. One dude left. And he's in 109. And I... Yep. Really? Interesting. Very interesting. 109G shot my track out. I don't even know what gun belts he would have to do that. They crashed into each other. All right, let's see what we can see here. That's it. That's gonna be the end of it. All right, guys. Well, we survived one. I don't think we're gonna get killed out at the end of this one. Finally, so there you have it. There is the first 10 for the T95 Doom Turtle. So we'll just take a look at the final score screen here. Hey, we finished parts in the 10th battle. That's pretty sweet. All right, thank you all for watching. I hope I didn't let my frustrations show through too badly there. I look forward to bringing you guys another first 10 soon. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you in the next video.